Organoids have now been created from stem cells to secrete the proteins that form dental enamel, the substance that protects teeth from damage and decay. A multidisciplinary team of scientists from the University of Washington in Seattle led this effort. The researcher says that this is a critical first step to their long-term goal to develop stem cell-based treatments to repair damaged teeth and regenerate those that are lost. The findings are published in the journal Developmental Cell. The researchers explained that tooth enamel protects teeth from the mechanical stresses incurred by chewing and helps them resist decay. It is the hardest tissue in the human body. Enamel is made during tooth formation by specialized cells called amyloblasts. When tooth formation is complete, these cells die off. Consequently, the body has no way to repair or regenerate damaged enamel, and teeth can become prone to fractures or subject to loss. To create amyloblasts in the laboratory, the researchers first had to understand the genetic program that drives fetal stem cells to develop into these highly specialized enamel-producing cells. To do this, they used a technique called single-cell combinatorial indexing RNA sequencing, siRNA-seq, which reveals which genes are active at different stages of a cell's development. This is possible because RNA molecules, called messenger RNA, mRNA, carry the instructions for proteins encoded in the DNA of activated genes to the molecular machines that assemble proteins. That is why changes in the levels of mRNA at different stages of a cell's development reveal which genes are turned on and off at each stage. By performing siRNA-seq on cells at different stages of human tooth development, the researchers were able to obtain a series of snapshots of gene activation at each stage. They then used a sophisticated computer program called the Monocle to construct the likely trajectory of gene activities that occur as undifferentiated stem cells develop into fully differentiated amyloblasts. With this trajectory mapped out, the researchers, after much trial and error, were able to coax undifferentiated human stem cells into becoming amyloblasts. They did this by exposing the stem cells to chemical signals that were known to activate different genes in a sequence that mimicked the path revealed by the siRNA-seq data. In some cases, they used known chemical signals. In other cases, collaborators from the UW Medicine Institute for Protein Design created computer-designed proteins that had enhanced effects. In the course of conducting this project, the scientists also identified for the first time another cell type called supodonodoblast, which they believe is a progenitor of odontoblast, a cell type crucial for tooth formation. The researchers found that together these cell types could be induced to form small three-dimensional multicellular mini-organs called organoids. These organoids themselves into structures similar to those seen in developing human teeth and secreted three essential enamel proteins, amyloblastin, amylogenin, and enamelin. These proteins would then form a matrix, a mineralization process that is essential for forming enamel with the requisite hardness would follow. The research team now hopes to refine the process to make an enamel comparable in durability to that found in natural teeth and develop ways to use this enamel to restore damaged teeth. One approach would be to create enamel in the laboratory that could then be used to fill cavities and other defects. Another more ambitious approach would be to create living fillings that could grow into and repair cavities and other defects. Ultimately, the goal would be to create stem cell-derived teeth that could replace lost teeth entirely. Teeth are an ideal model to work on the development of the other stem cell therapies.